Hello again, and welcome to the fourth passage in the letter of James. We're going to continue to be looking at this over the next many days and weeks and all the rest. And I want to remind you that I am doing my very best to have as little editing with this as possible, which the downside is it might get to be a little bit rambly. On the upside, we're doing things in kind of real time and sharing together in many ways what you might hear from me if we were sitting face to face and reading this text together. So let's pray, and we'll begin this next passage. Loving God, we do not often consider ourselves to be blessed when things we don't like are happening to us. And yet, in the Sermon on the Mount, we read Jesus tell us that blessed are so many people who the world would not necessarily consider blessed. And yet, Lord, if you call them blessed, they are. Lord, help us to see your blessing in the midst of inopportune situations. We send your Holy Spirit to be upon us and within us. Help us to read your scripture together. Lord, we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. So we're continuing on now with starting in verse 12 of James chapter 1, where James writes, "Blessed is a man who perseveres under trial. For once he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life, which the Lord has promised to those who love him. Let no one say when he is tempted, 'I am being tempted by God,' for God cannot be tempted by evil, and he himself does not tempt anyone. But each one is tempted when he is carried away and enticed by his own lust. Then when lust has conceived, it gives birth to sin. And when sin is accomplished, it brings forth death. Do not be deceived, my beloved brethren. Every good thing given and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shifting shadow. In the exercise of his will, he brought us forth by the word of truth, so that we would be a kind of first fruits among his creatures." As I was alluding to in my opening prayer here, there is a strong New Testament, especially tradition, of speaking of blessedness surrounding things that we might otherwise not be considered to be blessings. You know, Jesus talks about blessed are the meek, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, blessed are those who mourn, things like that. And here is James telling us that blessed is a man or a person who perseveres under trial. You know, and I guess we can imagine that persevering under trial is more blessed than to crumble under trial. But I think that most of us would say that we could do just fine without that blessing, Lord. Just if we can avoid the trial, we'd be happy to do that and miss out on the blessing of enduring in the trial, because enduring trials is not fun. Many people have endured very serious trials, and we all have endured various trials in our own way, even if they seem small by comparison. But I think that the real crux of this issue in this passage is this concern that James is clearly facing people who are saying, not just that they're being tempted or that they're having trials, but that it is God who is tempting them. And this is fascinating, because it could be very easy to say that, you know, blessed is the one who perseveres under trial. And it could be very easy to say that, you know, so the blessing is a trial. You know, the enduring under the temptation is a trial. Or the persevering is a blessing. And then in verse 17, he says, every good thing given and every perfect gift is from above. And this blessing of perseverance is a blessing. And so it'd be very easy to say, well, hang on a second. So if we have endured under trial, that's a blessing. We are blessed in the midst of all that. And if every gift is from God, does that mean that God caused the trial that led to the blessing? And James is saying that is not what we should say. And he says we should not be saying that God is tempting us, because God cannot be tempted by evil and does not tempt anyone. But each is tempted when he's carried away and enticed by his own lust. And so it seems to say that when we get carried away with our own weakness and our own frailty and our own inclination towards sin, that's when we find ourselves in temptation. Or being crushed under temptation. And yet to endure in the midst of that is a blessing and therefore a good thing. So it's not to say that temptation is good, not to say that our weakness that leads to temptation is good, but to say that in the midst of a thing that is not good, endurance and perseverance can still be a blessing and can still be from God. I bring this up anytime I talk about the topic of predestination, but there's a marvelous passage in the Old Testament where Joseph, you know, we were talking about doing Joseph in the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat, and I'm sure, and we will be doing it at some point. But there's this, the story of Joseph is fascinating on this topic, because Joseph is sold into slavery in Egypt. You know, gets taken down to Egypt, and the question that we could raise is, because then he turns that slavery around and he becomes one of the most powerful men in one of those powerful nations in the earth, and he does so much good. And so the question was it a good thing for Joseph's brothers to sell him into slavery? And because it would be very easy to look at the end of the book of Genesis and read that after Jacob dies, Joseph's brothers realize that now their father can't restrain their brother, and he would have every right, certainly it would be reasonable for him to exact his revenge on them. And at the end, so they make up a story to say, well, Jacob said, don't pay your brothers back. And Joseph says to his brothers, Joseph says, do not be afraid, for am I in God's place? As for you, you meant evil against me, but God meant it for good in order to bring about this present result, to persevere or to preserve many people alive. So therefore, do not be afraid. I will provide for you and your little ones. And so you have, at the conclusion of the story, you have Joseph making this declaration. You did something that you meant for evil, but God took that same action and meant it for good. And it'd be very easy to say that, that therefore, regardless of what the people thought, the action was good because God brought good out of it. I don't think that's what James is saying. I think James is saying, in the midst of bad circumstances, in the midst of temptations, it's tempting to say God is causing them. But in fact, he's saying that many of our temptations, at least, are not caused by God in any way, but are caused by our own foolishness, our own weakness, our own desire for things that we perhaps ought not to have. And yet, that doesn't nullify the fact that, it's like if you learn a lesson, and the reason you had to learn the lesson was because you did something dumb, it's amazing. You can still learn the lesson, and the thing you did could still be dumb. The dumbness of the choice doesn't nullify the legitimacy of the lesson learned, and that's important, And it doesn't. And the fact that you learned a lesson doesn't mean it wasn't still a dumb choice. And I think about that in my own life. That so here's James saying, you might be suffering temptation because of your own choices, because of your own. When you've been carried away and enticed by your own lust for whatever. And he says that might be the reason why you're tempted. But don't say that God tempted you, and yet we can say God taught me a lesson through it. We can say that given the fact that we had this experience, that we made this choice, we did this thing that was not good, and yet God was able to take that very same thing and transform it into something that is good. So it seems to me that's the solution to the riddle. There's a temptation to say, if it's good, it must have been from God. And so we learn from this temptation, or we learn from this struggle, or we learn from this endurance. And I don't think that James is saying that. James is saying that when you endure, when you persevere, it's good, regardless of what the source of it was. So that means whether it was through no fault of your own, or whether you were making foolish choices, or anything like that, the result, when you learn and grow, is good. And I think that's an important lesson to learn. And it seems to me that's the question. So in the midst of our situation now with the pandemic, we're in a situation, and we didn't cause it, or at least I personally didn't cause it, and you personally didn't cause it. We can talk to some people with authority and say maybe they had a bigger role, but it wasn't like we generally are reaping the results of our actions here. Although you could make an argument that anytime, biblically, every once in a while, there's a situation where. Because of a nation's sins, this has been put on the nation. And so you could interpret this as being there's some judgment on the world, in which case the lesson is always the same, which is turn back to God. So in the midst of all this, we should turn back to God. But the fact that we're facing this pandemic is not necessarily a specific response to a specific thing that I myself have done. And yet, I have the opportunity. But because it's not a good thing, because it's a temptation, it's a trial, it's important that I say, okay, regardless of how this happened, however this started, whatever choices I have made that were either wise or foolish in the past, today, what is God teaching me? What is God teaching you? And if we do that together, then we can say, if we endure through the temptations and we endure through the trials, James says, that's a blessing. And so I would encourage you today to be thinking about. In what ways is God calling you to endure? Whether it has to do with this coronavirus thing or whether it's something else altogether, how has God called you to endure in the midst of trials? And whether it was your fault that you went through the trials or something else, and how has God brought a blessing out of it? I encourage you to think about that today. We'll come back next week and we'll talk some more about the book of James. Have a good day.